Are you looking to build landing pages, but you just don't want something really complex? You want it to be simple and you want it to be fun. Well, there's a deal that's going on right now that does exactly that. It's called DaftPage, and it lets you build landing pages and a simple blog with it. Now, one of the key features that DaftPage has is that it lets you embed your Notion documents inside of that landing page. So basically, you can build pages based on Notion. Now, why is that something good or bad? Well, the good part about it is that it makes it more dynamic. That means that if you edit something in Notion, it's gonna automatically, well, update on your site. Aside from that, DaftPage lets you draw on your site. Now, it sounds kind of weird, but you're gonna see it on this video. So let's go jump over to this deal and check out DaftPage. So follow me to my desktop. What's up, everyone? My name is George and this is SaaS Master. Today we're going to check out DaftPage. Like I mentioned before, it's a website builder which is super easy to use and fun. Now be aware that with simplicity comes a simple builder. So it's not super complex. You're not going to build a wow site, like crazy site, but you can build nice sites that look really good. It's just going to depend on your imagination. Now, this deal, it's $69 for the lifetime deal, and well, it's unlimited sites. You can build as many as you want. And like I mentioned before, you can turn any Notion page into a website. That means that you can create a blog, embed Notion, and actually use it, which is one of the things that we're gonna go into in the beginning. Now, like I mentioned before, unlimited websites, unlimited blog posts, unlimited custom domains. Custom domains means that you can use your own domain that you already have purchased, and you can connect it via DNS. That means you can customize the domain and not use DaftPage as the subdomain, okay? Automatic HTTPS by Let's Encrypt and remove DaftPage branding. They do have a free tier and I do recommend that you check it out before buying the deal, just in case you find out that this deal is not for you or for you. So it lets you play around with the builder. And this is their landing page, which is DaftPage. They use a lot the unicorn and everything is based on being fun and easy to use. You can also draw on the page. Now, that's the landing page. And one of the things that they are thriving in is create a site with Notion. So people who already use Notion, well, it's pretty cool that you can embed this and make it a website. Now, for people who don't use Notion, don't worry about it. You can still build sites and use your custom domain and just, well, use it as a simple site builder, okay? So this is the roadmap. This is what's coming soon. I will leave that link in the description. And this is my DaftPage dashboard. Let me go back here. This is where I'm going to create my site. This is one of the ones I've been playing around with. And what I'm going to do is start from scratch. So let's go ahead and create a new site. I'm gonna name this, for example, SaaS Master. And I'm gonna go with green for this. And it's gonna ask me what typography do I want? Well, there's a couple of them. You can change this later if you want. In this case, I'll go with playful. And basically it adds this landing page, okay? So it's like a beginning, it's a header, and there's no more here, okay? Things that they should consider adding is templates. I think templates do help out a lot. It's one of my favorite things when I buy a deal is that they actually have templates because it's faster and easier for me to replace certain elements instead of doing everything from scratch. Just a little tip there, okay? So basically, if I click on any of these elements, I have the editor pop up over here. So for example, I have the layout, I have the media, I can turn it to left, keep it to the right. I can change this image. In this case, I have an option for Giphy, Sally, Remix Icon, Font Awesome, or I can add my own image from my desktop, just upload it, okay? I want rounded corners. In this case, it's a PNG, so obviously there's no rounding to go. Invert X or Y, shadows. I want to add a shadow there, but it's considering the square with that. The title for this, so I have all the elements right here for this particular box block. So right here, you can see build something great. Here it is. The description, the call to action. Here we go. That's for the button and the button link for it. Super simple. We can add more elements really quickly and easily. First, let me start off with a block to show you the Notion integration, okay? So I'm going to add a block, and these are all the blocks that we have available. I'm going to get started with Notion, okay? So there we go, this block has been added, and you can see that if you've used Notion before, you know that this comes as a default template. Now, it's a link that they're already using, but in this case, we are going to edit. There's this edit block pencil here, which I'm gonna click on it, and here's the link that we need from our Notion page, okay? So let's go into our Notion account. This is one of the ones I have, and user research, which is a default one that's there available. And what you have to do is actually share it, okay? And you have to enable share to web. This is the link that we're going to use. Don't use this link over here, copy link. Don't use that one. You gotta use the share one because the share one is for public and it's gonna be viewable. Over on this link, it's private. So that means that you have to be logged in to actually view it. Okay, so let's go back into our builder. So we're gonna add our page right there. And there we go, it just added it. See this block? It's available there. I can unmove the full page. I can make it full page. Disable header, disable icon. You can see how they are disappearing. Disable title, just in case you want that. Now this is out of phase, and that's because it's a really long one. So for example, even here, it's out of phase. So that's something that they have to consider. Here, that's all the options that you have right now. That's something I dislike about Daft Page. Like, I want to play with the margins. So here we have a big space on the left, and I can't do anything. I can't move it to the left, to the right, top, bottom. I can't tweak the pixels for the sizing of the margins. And let me show you a quick preview. So if I click on this right here, it's gonna show me what my page actually looks like right now. And here it is. See that there? So it's embedded there. Now, that's a simple use case. If you have a full page on Notion, you're gonna view the whole thing. Now, what I like about it is that Notion, you can do some automations, you can do a couple of things over there on Notion, and it's gonna dynamically change on your site because it's grabbing that information from Notion. That's what makes it interesting, okay? So that's the block for Notion. Let me remove it for now. There's several blocks available. You got navigation bar, hero, press logos, feature, testimonials, frequently asked questions, and they look pretty good, okay? So frequently asked questions. Another one that I like is pricing. Check out the pricing, looks really nice. We can edit these if I click on it. Go, let me go on the options there. Okay, so the background for it, the text, the pricing, override the style. We can change the style for this. Here's one of them. I can add another pricing to this, another one, and another one. And I like that it's simple and it looks nice, okay? It's super easy to build. Again, let me get rid of it, add a block here. There's testimonials, pricing, call to action, stats, custom code in case you want to use some custom code. For example, embedding something else, not Notion, something that you want to embed there. Custom code is really good to have there. The tweet grid, Instagram post, blog editor, feature grid, showcase, footer, Notion, which we saw already, and the whiteboard, okay? So the whiteboard, it gives you a big space, and that's a really cool feature that they have. Now, aside from the space, we can also use these options like draw. This is something that they strive upon, which is the draw. And we have the options here. So I can change the color to, let's use red so we can visually look at it. Let's go ahead and save the palette. We have the sizing for the brush. Well, it's not actually a brush because it's draw. Hope they add some brush, just like the one we're seeing here. So it kind of looks more realistic. But in this case, I'm going to click on the screen and it's gonna actually draw. So for example, I'll draw around this guy, what there, and that's gonna be on the page. Or if I want a sub line there, hey, check this out. So it looks more real. I mean, if you try to do this with underline, well, it's just a straight line and simple. What if I wanna do some wiggly there? I can do that there. Go ahead and save this. Let's go ahead and view it. And that's gonna be shown on your site. I mean, that what you draw there is actually viewable. Now, if you have one of those type of drawing boards, well, you can do something pretty cool with this. Now, again, I wish they add like a palette for this where you have brush types, brush sizes, if it's gonna be pencil, a pen. So I go a little bit more advanced on that. We also have the drop. So for example, if I wanna drop something here, so I'm gonna drop it. Here it is. We can drag it anywhere we want. Let me close this. Okay, dragging this little blob, clicking on it and putting it over here. And easy to do, right? The styles, if I want to change the styles for this, so it's style green. If I want to change it to, well, that's the font. The green there, if it's going to be the button sizes, it's going to be squared, rounded. We have the settings for this, for example, the name of the homepage. Custom code in case you want to use Google Analytics, Bing, and other things. The SEO purposes, title tag, meta description, open graph, and those kind of basic settings for SEO. We have the undo and redo for this. So what you kind of look right here is that it's super easy to use and build. If you don't like those kind of complex settings and you get like overwhelmed with that, then this is a great option because it's super simple to use. If you're looking for something more complex, then I'm guessing this won't be the deal for you unless they built in more features. Now, let me go ahead and open this site. I haven't connected my custom domain, but this is a live site there. I can just share the link and it's good to go. Other things that we have available is the blog for it. So if I want to create a blog for the one that we just created, here it is, create a blog because we want to create blog pages. Well, I can start writing and there we go. So we have the title, description, and write something. Now be aware that write something is pretty basic also. So if I write something here, and these are the elements that we have. So we can add an image or the assets that they have available, which is pretty simple, a spacer. There's also some code if we want to add that there. And that's it, all right? So we can add images, GIFs, and that kind of things. But it's kind of simple. We don't have blocks inside of the blog. So it's pretty simple in that sense. If I want to publish this, so I'll just put whatever and whatever for description, publish. And we have a blog published on that site. So super easy to build a site and start writing blogs. Like I mentioned before, this is super simple and easy to use and fun. You could say it's fun because we can draw on it and embed our Notion pages, which is what makes it really cool. Now, there you go. That's what's actually going on with DaftPage as of now. My recommendation is that if you're looking for something simple, go ahead. Grab it, easy to use, unlimited websites, custom domains, embed Notion, good to go. If you're looking for something more complex, more professional, this is definitely not the deal for you. In my use case, I'm thinking about it in case of grabbing it for something simple, but I am looking for more complex page builders. So I would be the type of people who, for example, would skip on this deal. But there you go, that is my honest opinion on DaftPage. If you guys want to grab it, that link will be provided in the description, which helps me out with a small commission, and it won't cost you a single cent more than what it already says there. But, well, there you go. I thank you all for watching. My name is George, and this is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.